Unbelievable, and I hope you enjoy it. And in particular, I want to thank Dublin City Council and the Dublin Chinese New Year's Festival Committee for all the hard work that's gone into putting this festival together. And in particular, I want to thank Declan Hayden, who's hiding here before me, behind me, for all the work that he's done. Wow, Lou, Happy New Year.
And to address us, 感谢市长阁下，我很高兴邀请到我们中国驻爱尔兰大使罗林全先生为我们致辞。
Lord Mayor Mantata, Mantago, councillors, distinguished guests, Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. 大家新年好。 Dear Greece, of the Dublin City Chinese New Year celebrations, this is the fifth consecutive year that such kind of celebration has been held, and also it is my very first time to attend. I would like to, on behalf of the Chinese Embassy, to extend my sincerest appreciation to the Dublin City Council and all those who have dedicated to the celebration. The Dublin City Chinese New Year celebrations are growing better and better in the past years, and with plenty of colorful activities, it has become a name card for the Dublin City, showing harmonious coexistence of different cultures in such an international capital. More and more Dubliners and Irish friends begin to know and love Chinese culture through it. Chinese people who live and study in Ireland can also feel the tension, friendship, and kindness from their Irish friends. It fully demonstrated the aim of the celebrations, that is to enhance mutual understanding of Chinese people and the Irish people. And to promote the bilateral relations between our two countries. Regarding the celebrations this year, I'm so happy to learn that the official website has been launched at the Chinese Film Festival. A carnival and some cultural lectures will be held. I'm sure that there is something we are all looking forward to. Hereby, I wish the celebrations every success. The year of rabbit, we have witnessed Beijing and Dublin becoming twinning cities, and the mayor of Beijing, His Excellency Mr. Guo Jinglong, paid a very successful visit to Dublin. Although Beijing and Dublin differ in size, I hold the belief that there are many things for the two cities to learn from each other, and the establishment of training agreements will bring real benefits to all people of the two cities. Moreover, China-Ireland friendship has also acquired stable developments, high-level visits, keep continuously exchanges and cooperation in various fields such as economic and trade, education, grow deeper. More Chinese visitors can experience the beauty of the Emerald Island. Emerald Island benefiting from the new visa policy. Dear friends, the Year of Dragon will come in 2 days. Actually, the dragon has already arrived here. So, for the traditional Chinese culture, dragon symbolizes his dignity, courage, and wisdom. Let us all hope that China-Ireland friendship takes a deeper root and plenty of variety in the Year of Dragon. And I wish all of you happy and healthy life and a prosperity year in the Year of Dragon. And I wish all the people present here, and I wish to present happiness to the country of Ireland, to all people of Ireland. Gauruf Mahagat. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ambassador. As this is the Year of the Dragon, we were delighted when one of our sponsors, in Tipperary Crystal, opened its first standalone shop just this month in Hangzhou in eastern China. We are delighted to have the Managing Director of Tipperary Crystal here with us tonight, who will make a special presentation now to the Lord Mayor and the Ambassador.
To be here tonight to help you celebrate the Year of the Dragon, we've made a special piece for each of you to present to you this evening as a form of our friendship to you. These pieces are copper wheel cut. They're the only two pieces in the world. They take a long, long time to make, and I hope you enjoy them. Will you both please join me here and I'll give you your piece each.
Chinese New Year Festival. Tonight, we are especially delighted to opening a groundbreaking exhibition in Sino-Irish art. Peking Opera is a form of traditional Chinese theater which combines music, vocal performance, mime, dance, and acrobatics. It arose in the late 18th century and became fully developed and recognized in the middle of the 19th century. The form was extremely popular in Qing Dynasty court and has come to regard it as one of the cultural treasure of China.
In partnership with the Gallery of Photography, Varvara Shevrova, the opera is an artist's insight into the fragile world of the Peking Opera, balancing moments of pure visuality with behind-the-scenes footage. The video underscores the striking avant-gardist qualities of this most traditional of Chinese art forms, and a specially commissioned score by composer Benoit Granier, which incorporates elements of traditional Chinese and contemporary electronic music.
The opera at the Gallery of Photography. I'm going to be brief and just say a few words about my involvement in the project. I was lucky enough to live in China for over 5 years with my family in Beijing, and even luckier to meet a number of extremely talented and versatile actors of Peking Opera Theatre, both in Beijing and in Shanghai. 2.5 years of dedicated work and collaboration with those actors contributed to the work that you will see in the Gallery of Photography today. Video installation, photography, and light boxes with sound represent the work that I have been developing during those years, and also represent the incredible connection that I have built with the Chinese cultural community. I hope this is going to continue the development of the relationship between Chinese and Irish cultural bodies, and I hope that this festival is going to mark the occasion of high quality and extremely fascinating collaborations that are going to happen in the near future.